Hello everybody, it's Licky Giraffe here with part 7. Yes, that's right, part 7 of my Dark Souls playthrough. I know, it's all very exciting. So, last we joined our merry hero, we defeated the Capra Demon and retrieved the key to the depths. So, next up then is we're gonna head down there and see what the dealio is. Do 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 do. Whack. Now, it's been a while since I last played this, so I can't remember whether I like the depths or not. Because I know we're getting closer and closer to Blighttown, which I definitely am not a huge fan of. Battle axe, ooh, and a waistcloth, sweet. Do in here, oh, kill the rat just in case. Oh, and he fell to the floor. The shortcut we opened earlier. Excuse me. And carry on. Run, 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 run. Ah. Undead Berg. You've never seen it before. Those guys over there, we don't need to do anything about them, and let's open the depths. Whee! Okay. Now, if I can remember, there's definitely some like hidden soul things around here I can pick up, but I don't remember exactly where. See? Check behind you. Guy would have come up and royally messed me up good, but I was paying attention, and by this stage of the game I know that if something doesn't feel right, then it probably isn't right, and I noticed that there wasn't a wall here, and indeed I was correct. So let's go back here, grab this soul as our merry reward. Unfortunately of course can't come up here, but you can see this guy over there is just standing there, so we'll have to keep an eye out for him. Some interesting camera quirkiness there. Smash, smash, smash. All these guys. Real pain in the ass, these guys, because they come at you in numbers, and if you're not careful, they will wreck you up. So make sure there's no one there, so we are rear secure. Ah, nuts. Now I've got myself into a corner, so. And ha, take that. Now we can drop down there, but I'm not going to. Stand, what I got on here? Gotta take this damn warhound thingamajig. Ah, nuts. Ah, oh, jeez. Poor timing on my part there. I see our guy over there chopping meat or something. Let's see if we can't get this freaking dog to come over here. Well, he just the hard way, and then we baggled this guy as well. So run up where we have a bit more room to maneuver. And wait. Is this guy coming? Oh. He was. I think he just got a little confused or something. What? Okay, this guy is... Something's messing with this guy anyway. Maybe his pathing is off. Anyway, hopefully we won't aggro anything else. There's these pillars between us and him. Learning his attack patterns. I don't think there's anything too mad about this guy, to be honest. I wonder if I can backstab him, actually. Probably can. Oh yeah, there you go. And let's finish. Ha. Easy peasy. Sweet ember. If I can remember, you can drop down here and do something, but I don't remember what. I don't want to screw myself over, so I'm not going to. Let me think. I'm thinking of a ring, but I'm not sure if I have it. No, I don't. I think it's a ring. Oh, I think it's a ring you pick up in Blighttown. Oh, no. Get out of there real quick. Gosh darn, these guys are just messing up my day. Yeah, this ring you can wear that means that water doesn't like impede you like this. Because against these really mobile foes, be a real annoyance. But I do not remember where it is. It's either in the gardens or it's down in Blighttown. For the life of me, I can't remember. So, this dude.
Would have been a supper without you. Been eaten alive. Thank you. I am Luensius. With the great swamp, I will not forget my debt to you.
Woo.
Oh, hello.
Super. Nothing more of interest. Now, if I remember correctly, there was... there he is. Plump. Now, long straight corridor, definitely favoring melee. But, we're able to... Oh, another backstab, ho ho! Fire tonight. Well, rather this morning, since it's the morning here. Haha! Ooh, a sack. Super fun. Dun, dun, do, 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 do. So you could have just dropped down here. And potentially skipped all this, I'm not sure. I, for the life of me, can't remember. So I'm gonna take an SS flak now because I have loads of them. And so you go in here and it's like, ooh, look, a soul, how easy. But wait. Nasty slime stuff. It's also a massive pain to like attack or anything. Ah. Rare. I get 100 souls for all of my hard work. And then that soul. If I can remember. Bunch in there. I'm just gonna try run down the end because I'm not fighting all of those damn slimes. Nuts. No, no, no. Come on, get off me, get off me, get off me! Yeah. Now let's quickly get out of here. Thankfully, they're also very slow moving. And hello, Mr. Bonfire. Next other, I use the master key to open this door, so I'm not sure if I would have been able to open this door normally. Honestly, can't tell you. But I'm going to rest here. And just enough to level up to. How convenient. Let's give us a little bit more endurance. See, I'm not sure what key you need to open this door then if you don't have the master key. I'm honestly not sure. And, ooh, actually what I'm going to do is, well, attack me. Oh! So you can see these guys, pretty damn strong. But what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use some humanity. Make myself human and I'm going to light this bonfire. It's a pretty good bonfire. I think humanity. God, I do not have that much humanity. Oh wait, hold up. First Halloween. Yes, I didn't need to use my humanity. Humanity restored. Perfect. And now kindle the bonfire. Woo. And there we go. Back to 10 Estus flasks. So now let's try not get wrecked by this chap here. Avoid all of the oozes and carry on down to our great journey. So we see a giant pulsating red thingamajigger here, along with a ladder. Now I don't remember the purpose of the ladder. I'm pretty sure it's a shortcut that we can't access yet, so I'm just going to ignore it. A lot of rats over there. Oh no. Just not strong enough to kill them in one hit. How irritating. Luckily they're pretty stupid, so red axe. It's no claymore though. Meaty globule things. Ooh, look, I had put my shield up there as a rat jumped out of that box. So I think comes up a few times where things jump out of boxes, but here was a good chance to introduce it to the player, you know, so relatively safe. One rat jumps out of the box, if you get hit, no biggie, because you're kind of close to a bonfire anyway. But then later on we might see this done in like more serious circumstances where there's more enemies and there's more risk, but because you've shown it to the player now initially, it's up to them to keep an eye out for boxes and to be wary that there may be maybe enemies inside. So I believe this is the first time in the game that enemies can hide in boxes. Or at least enemies are shown to be hiding in boxes, should I say. Okay, so get all stabby. I think it might be the sewer chamber key then. That lets me go into that that previous place. So let's carry on. Won't go down there because if you fall down, you're in the place where all the gecko thingamajiggers. Now, I don't remember if this is fight time. I think it may well be. But I'm feeling pretty good, so let's go for it. And no. Got us all psyched up for nothing. That's okay. No biggie. So let's just try to get this guy's attention. There we go. Get him to come up to us. Luckily now he's good and weak. That goes down very easily. No. Darn giant rats. Ooh, pillage body. Humanity, sweet. Yeah, I'm surprised I don't have more humanity. I'm not sure where it all went. See, there we go. Boxes again. This time there are two rats. And if you're, say, rushing and trying to run past that Chandler guy, you get ambushed by these guys, attacked, and then everyone just falls on you and you die. And exploring, get our large titanite shard, which is great. And now we're kind of scared of boxes too. But we notice them. You know, so right after these guys, they popped out, you see them again, we're like, oh shit, boxes, get ready. Nothing comes, roll in, haha, game's laughing at you. But it's done its job, mechanic's done its job, you're now wary of boxes. Or at least you should be at this point. So that not all boxes are bad, but some of them are, and so you should treat all boxes with suspicion. Now, I'm trying to remember which way to go down here. Pretty sure. What? There we go. Just need to be careful. You know, don't follow the rats who are going to run away. Key to make silly decisions. So you can hear the game goes quiet. You can hear that weird sound. It's like, oh, what is that weird sound? That is the sound of the geckos. Let's see, I have tennis flasks. So I'm gonna drink one now, just to get full health. Just to be careful. And let's engage the giant rat person. So it's got a big great axe in its eye, that looks pretty cool. Oof. Hefty chunk of stamina gone there. Now, some might say, ah, oh, you're not doing it right, you're cheating. But one of the things I like about Dark Souls is that, you know, if you can find a way to beat the boss, kind of like say in a cheesy fashion, it doesn't try to punish you for doing that. Oh, ow. doesn't try to punish you for doing that. It doesn't try to stop you. If you can find a cool way to beat the boss, or say if the boss accidentally falls off a ledge, like the demon guy at the start did for me, then it's fine. It's fine with that. You know, and it almost encourages you to be smart about it. You know, so like, why do I need to come all the way out here and battle the giant rat? Why can't I just stay in here and chop away at him? You know, the game gives you the option. I really appreciate it. So, this is the guy. This is the guy. Sorry, earlier. Stairs things that we saw earlier too. Now I'm trying to remember because I always get a little bit fuzzy around this area. I'm pretty sure. Go down here. Okay, I'm not sure I was supposed to do that. I think I was supposed to do it better. But hey. What you gonna do? You can see now there's that weird gecko thing. Such an odd looking monster. Like, really, really odd. Ooh, shit. Gotta watch out. Gotta be careful. Do not want to get cursed and die down here. That would be a royal pain in the ass. Come on, Mr. Ratman. Come get me. I like how in this area as well, some rats are quite aggressive. They will come and attack you, whereas some rats kind of try like run away and hide. It's interesting. Forces you to deal with the rats differently, I suppose. So again, there's more geckos. Gotta be careful. Multiple geckos, very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. Because you can stand in their gas stuff too long, and then suddenly, boom, you're frozen, you die. Now you see them moving around, and that's bad. That means they've locked onto you, and they're moving towards you. So God only knows when he's going to find his way towards me. But there is no doubt in my mind it will be at an inconvenient time. Under my eye, most defenseless. Trick is just kill them quickly, be decisive, be careful. Be patient. Pretty much just, you know, be all the things Dark Souls wants you to be at this perilous time. Oh, there's another one. Bleh. Gulp. Another one bites the dust. And retreat. Don't want to get it surrounded by them. Don't want to do anything rash. You just want to take your sweet time. I honestly can't remember if that just drops me down onto. I can't see anything dangerous down there. So, I'm just going to try to roll over it. No, that didn't work. That didn't work at all. But, it's okay. Ring of the Evil Eye, whatever that is. So I got this guy, and... haha, silly gecko. paying attention. Oh dear. Oh, oh. As I was telling him, as I was chastising him for not paying attention, there I was, not paying attention. I'm very almost ran into three geckos. I would have looked quite the fool. Quite the fool indeed. Okay, let's grab a saw. Then let's go back and try again. Boom. Easy money. Yes. Perfect. Okay, so we know that down there is a dead end, which is fine. The less time, the less places we need to explore in here, the better. So, run we back we go. Down here. Around. Now, back to where we originally came in, so we head on down this way now. There's a crate. See the crate? Can never be too careful about crates. Ooh. Dark Spirit Knight Kirk. Alright, let's defeat Kirk, everybody. See what Kirk has. What you got, Kirk? What you got? Oh no. I see it's quite heavy as well. We rolled. Trying to backstab him, not really working though. Oh, there we go. Haha, yes. Take that, Kirk. Boom. Down you go. Sweet. Let's take an S flask, just keep ourselves nice and topped up. Ooh, 12,000 souls, Greggy. That is a lot of souls. So let's make sure we play good and careful. And not die needlessly. Okay, cool. So this is where, I think this is where we should have ended up if I had done things properly, not goofed up. If we run up here, I think this leads us back. Yes, yeah, yeah. There it is. That's the ladder. Brilliant. Out of goo dropping everywhere. Die, rat creature. Die, rat man. And then, oh yeah, here we are. This is the path to the monster. We'll go down there just yet. It's locked. That is, I believe that's the way to Blighttown as well. Well, it's one of the ways to Blighttown. I'm Don of Xena. I'm just a peddler of sorts. I adore trinkets and oddities, so I trade for them. Let's talk to this guy some more, see what he has to say. Oh. What a jip. Ah, well, nothing too interesting. Well, that is a shame. But no one come back. Not it. They'll See, I didn't actually quite see what Kirk gave me. Did he give me anything cool? Because, man, like I said, I didn't quite see. Ooh, Baldur Gauntlets, those would be quite good. I lose magic defense and lightning defense, but I gain quite a lot in physical defense. I have to lose bleed and poison resistance. It's a tough one. Let's see, what else? What else we got? God, I just remember what the hell Kirk did give us, if anything. I'm pretty sure I definitely saw some stuff. Oh, maybe Spike Shield. Good old Claymore. Oh, that's a good name. Okay, alright. Going to be a relatively quick video this time. Unfortunately, so I'm not going to battle the whatever that monster is, the boss monster is called. I'm just going to go back to my bonfire, use my souls. And we'll call it there. As I do not have the time on, unfortunately. But, the next video at least will be right beside him, so we'll be able to jump right into the action. See, so. Some leveling, I can get what, 2 levels now. Extra 1 weapon damage, how exciting. Tough. More endurance or more vitality? I'll go more endurance. Get up to 24 too. Confirm that. And then, yeah, I guess we'll leave it there. So thanks so much for watching, guys. And I'll see you next time.